Find the best people you want to get close to. Find them. Get close to them. Do whatever it takes to learn everything you can from them. Because when you do, you're going to be a lot better off. I want to see other people win. We're so focused on ourselves in the beginning that we forget about other people. But to build an empire, you can't do it with one person.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. As we continue this series, I'm going to focus more on linguistics and some of the patterns that are thrown out and used in society and to make sure that you avoid them, right? So this would be like five phrases that should make your antenna go up, or five phrases that if you hear them, you should run the opposite way, right? And I want to cover some of these because, again, a lot of these go under the radar and you didn't even realize what you're being told, and usually what's said after can make or break you, because in the situation where somebody gives you advice, you'll wholeheartedly listen to it when it could be absolute bullshit. But because they say this and we're so used to hearing these things, again, it goes under the radar. So you have to be very, 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 very careful. Okay? So the first one is, that's just how I am. Okay? Oh, man. Okay. When I hear this, it presupposes, right? It presupposes that there's no choice and that you can't make a change. So you may say that to yourself to like excuse a behavior. Like, let's say you blow up on somebody, right? I hear this all the time. Like, oh, if you're Hispanic, like you have a bad attitude, right? I hear that, especially for women. Well, that implies that you can't change that. That's stupid, right? You're putting somebody into a box and implying that they're just that way and they can't change, which is dumb. I've seen people, including myself, make tremendous transformations, right? And you know some of these stereotypical things, right? But that's what they'll say. Well, you know, like someone says, well, I'm bitchy, but that's just how I am. No, you can change it. You're just shunning away the responsibility of making the change. Now, it may be out of ignorance in the sense that they don't know they can change, or they think, well, you know, that's just my DNA. I'm going to be outspoken, or I'm going to be loud, or whatever it is, right? You can fill in the blank. But you have to understand that at the individual level, you can make a change. So if we were told, because your family does this or that's in your history, you can't change, that's bullshit. You can change. I've changed. I've seen a lot of people change. You've seen people go through tremendous transformations, I'm sure, in your personal circle or in your life or online or somebody you follow or whatever. So we know it can happen. Now, we fall into these patterns because we see other people say this shit and we think that's just the way it is. Newsflash, it's not. But it requires you taking personal responsibility and making a change. So please stop saying this, or when you hear this, you know that what's about to come out of somebody's mouth is probably disempowering, and they have this illusion that they're not in control of their own lives and their own character, when in actuality, they are, because you can mold it, all right? Number two, that's what everyone does. What do you mean? Who's everyone, right? That tells me more than likely what I was handed was an opinion. Right? That's what everyone does, right? So then I return and say, so if everybody jumps off a bridge, is that what the fuck I'm gonna do? I'm gonna jump off a bridge? Doesn't make sense. So sometimes I give, like in response, an extreme example like that, jumping off a bridge, just so people can catch how ludicrous it is what they're saying, okay? So again, when you hear that and you're getting advice, you want the antenna to go up because it's probably opinion, or they just assume the mob rule, meaning if a lot of people are doing it, it must be right. Now, when you flip this on its head, I actually use this for influence because I know people think this way. So if I'm in a situation where somebody maybe for the salespeople is unsure about what to do, I'll even ask them, you want to know what most people do in this situation, sir or ma'am or Mr. and Mrs. Johnson? They blank. And then I fill in whatever I want them to do. They go ahead and move forward. They sign, they buy the product or whatever because they know it's the best thing. And suddenly they're social proof because everybody does it. That's what that is. That's social proof, this one. That's what everyone does. Now, again, you can use it as a covert influence technique if you want, right? I'm assuming you have a high level of ethics and you're honest, because if most people are doing it, like most people buy from you, then you can say that because you're being honest. But what you have to understand is, again, in the context of advice or those kind of things, life direction, whatever, you're going to hear this to justify actions. So again, when you hear it, you want the antenna to go up and you want to look a little bit deeper. Because a lot of times, again, this is just stuff that's handed down, as are most of these things. So you cannot allow it to fly under the radar. All right? So that's number two. Number three, someone told me, someone said. I see this like on YouTube all the time, right? I'll give an advice on a certain subject and then they'll say, man, this is a great video, but someone told me blah, blah, blah. I'm like, who the fuck is someone, dude? Like, who's someone? So you just stopped at a gas station. Someone's like, oh, you're in real estate. Here, let me give you some advice. And that's someone, right? So typically when you hear this, you're getting advice again, or someone is attempting to give you direction. So what you need to do as the receiver of this is say, okay, first you ask, who is someone? And I say that to people. Someone will tell me, hey, someone said that you shouldn't blah, blah, blah. I'm like, okay, who is someone? And they'll say, oh, my mom. I'm like, okay, well, we're talking about sales or real estate, and I'm the professional in the industry. Is your mom in the industry? No. Okay, then there's no argument, right? Just because someone says something doesn't mean it's true or that it's valid or that it weighs more than my advice or vice versa. Now, obviously, you can make the decision on who you're going to listen to. But when you hear this, you need to be absolutely certain that you pass it through that filter. Otherwise, if, again, you're genuinely looking for advice or direction on something, then you talk to the top person, whoever that is, then someone else who has nothing to do with that industry or thing, and you're weighing their opinion evenly, that's pretty foolish, because that person is certified in that area, whatever that area is. So again, when you're getting advice, when it's being handed down and you hear that, someone, ask, who is someone? Who is someone? Someone said, who is someone? Right? And people, you'd be surprised. People listen to that shit, try it out. After you watch this video, go out and say, oh yeah, someone told me blah, 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 blah. And they'll be like, oh yeah? No one's gonna say who is someone unless it's me or somebody who watches me and does it, right? It's crazy. It's crazy. It actually makes me laugh, right? Number four, no one or everyone. They try to group people. Hey, no one does that, or everyone knows that. Who is no one and who is everyone? You mean to tell me that every single person doesn't abide by this philosophy or believes this or believes that, right? You know where you catch a lot of this shit? Again, in the media, or somebody trying to push a certain agenda. Because this is that sneaky shit, linguistically, that slides under the radar, that no one really catches. See, I said no one. See, even I said it, and I've said that a million times in videos, and you probably didn't even catch it. So we need to look. These, I call them like trigger words that should get your antenna to go up. Right? Your critical factor in your mind, right? We learned that in hypnosis. For you to question it and maybe not get totally defensive, but say, I need to pay a little closer attention, or if they cite a source or say a specific thing, I need to look at it. I need to pay a little bit closer attention and research it, or maybe not accept it at face value. So when I hear like, oh, everyone, I think we said it up here too, that's what everyone does, right? Again, who is everyone? Again, they're trying to group it and say that this is just accepted, widely accepted, and everybody does it. I don't think so. I don't think so. So again, when I hear this, I'm going to, again, be like, what do they mean by that? And I'll look into it a little bit more. So again, that's something that you want the antenna to go up with. All right, here's the last one. You're not supposed to. You're not supposed to do that. I was told. You're not supposed to wear earrings. You're not supposed to speak your mind when you're on camera. You're not supposed to talk about politics, right? Or your opinion on politics or anything. You're not supposed to get tattoos. You're not supposed to wear anything outside of the traditional suit, right? Your suits are too flashy. You're not supposed to wear that. You're not supposed to do social media and video because it's a waste of time. You're not supposed to go door to door. You're not supposed to make cold calls. I mean, I can keep fucking going on. Everything I told you, I've heard from people. You're not supposed to fill in the blank. Who the fuck gave that person the manual to life or real estate? That was my question. Oh, I'm not supposed to wear earrings? Who the fuck told you that? Give me the manual that says in life, you're not supposed to wear earrings. You're not going to be taken seriously. You know why? My success in what I've done has proven all of those theories false. So this, you're not supposed to, where the fuck did that come from? Like, do you personally know the God of the universe? And he just consults with you and says, hey, tell the people they're not supposed to do that. Where does this come from? See, but nobody questions it. We're told, hey, you know what? You're not supposed to do that. And we're like, okay. We're like good little workers and employees. Okay, I won't do it. And then you never question it. You never question it. That's the problem. So again, what are you being fed with? This is the geist, with this is like the back door where the negative influence and persuasion comes in. Because anything said after that, most people will accept it. I could even be on the street, like on a certain place, and say, hey, you're not supposed to walk on this block right now. The city, I can just make some shit up. The city said you can't walk on this piece of cement, so you have to walk around. I guarantee you 99% of people will just walk around it and not even question it. Who the fuck am I, that person on the side of the street, to tell you you can't walk on the sidewalk? But no one will say shit, right? No one will say shit. So again, these are just some things to get you to question and use a little bit more critical thinking and logic when you guys are receiving advice or when you're living your life, because as I've said these, I guarantee you all of you are like, fuck, I've heard this a million times, or what do you mean? There's nothing wrong with that. There is something very wrong with it. Now, I'm going to continue the series because this is just the tip of the fucking iceberg, like this much. But again, I want you to start paying more attention because that's what this is about. A lot of my videos recently and over the years have been about raising awareness and giving you more control over your life. Because if you're getting advice and listening to things that start and phrases to start with this, you're probably getting a lot of ass backwards advice that are just opinions, and then you wonder why your life isn't going the way you want it to go. Okay, so take a look at these again. If you guys have any recommendations for other ones that you want me to discuss, if you want me to elaborate more on this and give you more, go ahead and leave a comment below and maybe give me a thumbs up or say part two, that way I know. But other than that, make sure you guys like and subscribe to the channel if you want to support. I think it's pretty crazy that I think 60 or 65% of my views are coming from people who aren't subscribed, which is kind of weird. Just subscribe to the fucking channel. What are you waiting for, right? Check out my two new channels. Check out Modern Success. Link is in the description. It's my personal coaching program for my tribe. We're getting closer to 300 members, so I'm excited. And lastly, if you guys are interested and you're a part of the real estate world, make sure you go to partner with Team BC if you want to join my squad. Watch the video. If it makes sense to you, then go ahead and schedule a call and we'll chat. All right, that's it for this one. Peace.